الحمد لله الذي أضعف ما حمده جميع خلقه كما يحبه ويرضاه سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي اللهم اجعلنا دعاة إليك وإلى رسولك أما بعد فقد قال الله تعالى في كتابه الكريم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والمؤمنون والمؤمنات بعضهم أولياء بعض يأمرون بالمعروف وينهون عن المنكر ويقيمون الصلاة ويؤتون الزكاة إلى آخر الآية وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الدين النصيحة صدق الله العلي العظيم وصدق رسول الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين ومن الشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين Indeed, all praises are for Allah. We praise Allah and we thank Allah. We glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah who is Al-Ahad, Allah who is One, Allah who is Wahid, Allah who is Qahhar, Allah who is Al-Awwal, Allah is the First, Allah who is Al-Akhir, Allah is the Last, Al-Batin, Al-Zahir, Allah Al-Ghani, Allah Al-Basir, Allah Al-Mughni, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Lahul Asma'ul Husna. To Allah belongs the most beautiful of names. It is He, Allah, who has chosen Al-Mustafa, the chosen one, Al-Mujtaba, Al-Muzammil, Al-Mudassir, Al-Adlul Amin, Al-Sadiq, Muhammad Al-Nabiyyin, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Khatimun Nabiyyin, Wa Rahmatul Al-Alamin. We send peace and blessings upon Rasulullah, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, whom Allah has chosen. And sent us the last prophet, the seal of the Anbiya, Ashraful Anbiya, the best, the most honored of all the prophets, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. We send peace and blessings upon him, on his faithful companions, and all those who will follow with Ihsan ila Yawmiddin. My dear brothers, my dear sisters, indeed Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala has continued to keep his contract with the Muslim Ummah. Allah has continued to keep his contract with Nas and mankind. Allah has continued to keep his contract with all the makhlukat and all the creations that he had created. Because the very first thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked us while we were in the wombs, while we were in the world of the souls, in the loins of our father Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, when Allah questioned us, Alastu bi Rabbikum, am I not your Lord? What was our response? What was the response of Bani Adam, the entire makhlukat of this insan, the entire creation of mankind that was living in the loins of Adam alayhi salam? Their response was, O Allah, you are indeed our Lord. It is mankind who has broken the contract. Allah promised, as long as you continue to worship me, I will continue to do for you. As long as you continue to worship me, I will continue to respond to you. As long as you continue to obey me, I will continue to bestow and grant upon you. The day we turn our backs from Allah, still Allah is so merciful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hands are always open to receive us. This is Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And from amongst his teachings, we can see when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted him with that title of being Rahmatul Alameen, a mercy to the world, we can really and truly appreciate the kind of mercy that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam showed not only to his ummah, but those people who even denied Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even those people who denied Allah and worshipped others other than Allah. Even the animals, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was so merciful to the animals. Once a cat was lying on his cloak. A cat was lying on his cloak and it was asleep. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not want to disturb that cat in the least. He took a scissors and he cut right around where the cat was sleeping and left that cat sleeping there. The kindness of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a Bedouin Arab, a non-Muslim, he entered the masjid. He started to urinate in the masjid. Sahabas were ready to grab at his throat. They were ready to strike him. They were ready to beat him. They were ready to take his head off his body. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says to them, "What? No, leave him. Let him finish. Let him finish." How would we respond to something like that? How would we respond to a disbeliever? We have to follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Every day we claim, we are following the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How much of the sunnah are we following? Is it only when I follow a sunnah, I am following the sunnah? What about the 100 I'm leaving out and the 1 I'm making amal upon? And still, we criticize and we condemn and we chastise everybody. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah for himself told us in the glorious Quran that his character was the noble Quran. He lived and he died the Quran. He slept and he woke the Quran. His entire lifestyle, the way he lived, the way he operated with people, the way he transacted in business, the way he attended to the poor and the needy, the way he dealt with the rich. Subhanallah, every single aspect of his life was that of the Quran. The Quran is a book that guides, my dear brothers, my dear sisters. The Quran, it is a book of guidance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses this book to guide the hearts of the mukminin and the mukminat, and even the kafirin, even the disbelievers, even the munafiqeen, even those people, subhanallah, who one time they say, we are with you, and the other time, we are not with you, the hypocrites. Allah uses this book to guide the hearts of the believers, mankind in general. This is why when Allah begins this book, and Allah starts this book with Surah Al-Fatiha, what we are asking Allah for, what we are begging Allah for in Surah Fatiha, Ihdina Sirat al-Mustaqim, Ihdina Sirat al-Mustaqim. Coming just after Surah Fatiha, Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah begins this surah by saying, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. That is the book in which there is no doubt. You will find guidance there for those people who fear Allah. We are asking for guidance. Allah is saying, this is the book. And it is guidance, guidance. How many of us understood the farewell sermon of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he says, I am leaving two things behind. If you hold on to them, you will never go astray. The book of Allah and my sunnah. The book of Allah and my sunnah. Let us take a yardstick and let us see how close we are to the book of Allah, or how far we are from the book of Allah, how close we are to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how far away we are from the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We have to analyze the situation. Every single day something is happening in the world. Every single day it's a new day. Are we waiting for when the sun rises from the west? When the sun rises from the west, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, at that point in time, anyone who comes and says, Amantu billah, oh Allah, I believe in you, I believe in Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, at that point in time, no iman will be accepted. No iman will be accepted. When the sun rises from the west, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the hadith comes in Sahih Muslim. It says, Inna Allah ta'ala yabsutu yadahu billayli liyatuba musiyun nahar. Every single night, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah stretches out his hand. Allah stretches out his hand in the night in order for that person who had sinned during the day, that he will turn to Allah and make repentance to Allah. Every single night Allah is doing that. وَيَبْسُتُوا يَدَهُ بِالنَّهَارِ لِيَتُوبَ مُوسِيُ اللَّيْلِ. And Allah, during the course of the day, He stretches out His hands. He extends His hands of rahmah, His hands of mercy for that one who was sinning in the night, so that during the course of the day, he will make repentance to Allah. And the hadith ends by stating, حَتَّى تَطْلُعَ الشَّمْسِ, until the sun rise from the west. Until that time happens, then the doors of Allah will become closed. How many people we are seeing today, my dear brothers, my dear sisters? People are looking for spouses. Allah is responding to everybody. Some are calling Allah in different languages, Chinese, Japanese, English, Spanish, French, you name it. How many different languages people are calling on Allah? And Allah, Allah is listening to each and every single one of them individually. Individually. How many people can we listen to at one time? How many people? One talking Urdu, one talking Spanish, one talking French, one talking English. And we have to listen to all of them at one time. How many can we listen to? Allah is listening to every single one of them. Oh, I'm looking for a good spouse. Oh, I'm looking for a righteous spouse. And Allah is blessing them with it. Allah gives them spouses, and now, oh Allah, we want some children. Oh Allah, we want some children. Oh Allah, we want some children. Allah is bringing kids. Allah is giving them. Now the children start to go astray. Oh Allah, guide our kids. Guide our kids. Everybody is making a different dua, and Allah is answering every single dua. If not here, in the hereafter. Allah is answering. Allah is answering. Allah will continue to respond as long as the servant continue to cry to Allah. As long as the servant continue to call on Allah, Allah will continue to respond. Allah likes that. Allah likes when we call upon Him. Allah likes to hear our voices. We become frustrated. The first call and the second call and the third call and no response. We become frustrated. We stop calling. We stop asking. We start a call on people now. Allah is not listening. While Allah was enjoying the voice of the believer, Allah was enjoying it. Allah was having a good time listening to His servant, looking at the servant, going through trials and tribulations, going through problems, going through hardships, and still not losing hope in Him. Allah was having a good time with that. It was only a matter of time when Allah would have wiped away the distress and the grief from the face of that servant and bring about the smile on the face of that servant. Now that servant has turned to somebody else. Allah has set forth a pattern. And this is why, as believers, when we fall, Allah is always there to lift us up. No matter how hard you might fall, Allah is waiting to lift you up. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we cry with pain to Him, Allah is ready to bring a smile and joy and peace and happiness on our faces. With every hardship, Allah is waiting to bring ease. With every difficulty, Allah is waiting to bring ease. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to understand Allah. We have to understand what Allah wants from us. Allah brings forth many examples in the Quran. Many nations of the past, in Surah number 9 of the Quran, Surah Tawbah, Allah mentions an incident in the Quran about the different nations in the past, the nations of Nuh alayhi salam, the nations of Ad, Thamud, the ancient nations of Lut alayhi salam, Madian, the people of Madian. All these nations, Allah sends prophets to them. Different prophets came to them. Subhanallah. With one message and one message alone, to come towards this one Allah. Believe in this one Allah. Accept this one Allah as Rabbul Alameen. They all rejected. Allah showed us, we are the living proof that we can open the Quran and we can read of their stories. We can read of the lessons that was based upon what they did and what happened to them. Every nation that disobeyed Allah, Allah sent a different punishment to them. Destroying them, wiping them out from the face of the earth because of their disobedience to Allah. But Allah says, for you people, for you, Allah says in regards to the believing men, the believing woman, Allah says, بَعْضُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْضُ. You are friends and protectors and helpers one to the other. Those of you who say that you believe, those of us who say that we believe, the men and the women, Allah is saying, you are friends and helpers for each other. In goodness, why? Because يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. You will do good and you will enjoin on other people goodness too. You won't keep the goodness for yourself. You alone won't come and pray salat. You will tell your brother and your sister about salat. You alone won't give zakat. You will tell them about it. You will tell them about fasting when you fast. You will tell them about the kindness to your parents. You will tell them about honesty in their trade and business. You will tell them also because you are enjoining that. You are enjoining that. يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. You are also staying away from bad things. The believing men and the believing women, friends to each other, they stay away from bad things, they stay away from wrong things, and they enjoin that upon others too. It's not that you are not doing it and you're telling other people to do it. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لِمَا تَقُولُونَ مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ. Allah is saying, oh you who believe, people who have iman, people who have iman, Allah is addressing them in this ayah. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, lima taquluna ma la taf'alun. Why do you say that which you yourself, you are not doing it? You telling people to pray, you not praying. You telling people learn to read the Quran, you for yourself don't even know how to do it. Allah says, kabura maqtan indallahi an taqulu ma la taf'alun. It is a grievous sin and crime in the sight of Allah, a grievous penalty in the sight of Allah, that you say to people that which you yourself you're not doing. So Allah is saying the believing men, the believing women, they will enjoin good upon themselves and they will encourage others to do good. They for themselves will stay away from bad, they will encourage others to stay away from bad. وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ. They will establish the prayer. Establish the prayer. وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ. They will give their zakah. They will encourage others to pray. They will encourage others to give. وَيُطِيعُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. And most definitely, my dear brothers, my dear sisters, their obedience is to Allah and His Rasul, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. No disobedience. No disobedience. They will obey Allah. They will obey the Rasul, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is how the friendship is built. This is what friendship is built upon. Friendship is not built upon who have more money, I could line with him, he's my friend. Who have the best ride, I would line with him, he's my friend. She's my friend. Who looks pretty, who looks handsome, we will hang out with them. Friendship is not built upon that. These are the conditions that friendship is built on. Al-mar'u ala dini qalilihi. A man is upon the path of his friend. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said it. So who are the friends amongst the believing men and the believing women? Because there will be believers who will tell you to do something and they themselves not doing it. There will be, and we see it with our very eyes. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, the true believers amongst the men, amongst the women, this is their quality. These are their qualities. They will enjoin it upon themselves and they will also enjoin it on others. They will stay away from it. And they will also encourage others to stay away from it. They will obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They will obey the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah is saying at the end of that ayah, what will Allah give to them? What will Allah give to them? Ulaika sayarhamahum Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in regards to those people, Allah will send His special mercy upon them. What does it take to enter paradise? What does it take to be admitted into Jannah? Is it amal? Is it deeds? Is it actions? It's the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is Allah saying here? Allah will send upon them. Allah will give to them. Allah will grant them His special mercy. Subhanallah. Inna Allah azizun hakim. Allah is mighty. Allah is wise. Allah is mighty, Allah is wise. Allah knows why He does whatever He does. Allah has taqat and quwwah and power. Allah can do anything He wants. Then Allah says, in regards to this mercy, Allah says, وَعَدَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ. The promise that Allah has made with the believing men and the believing women, this friendship, this bond that they made together, subhanAllah. What is the promise Allah is making with them? Allah is saying, جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِن تَحْتِيَ الْأَنْهَارِ. Jannah, paradise, gardens beneath which rivers flow. Allah has given us a promise. If we will stick to the conditions, Allah has given us this promise. He's going to give us gardens beneath which rivers flow. Allah is not going to put us in there for a day or 2 days or live like how we would live here 10, 20, 50, 60, 100 years. Khalidina fiha. Forever and ever, Allah is saying. You will dwell in there forever. How many of us in our nice comforts at home, our luxurious comforts at home, we say to ourselves, "Boy, I don't want to die and leave here, you know. I don't want to go from here. Everything is so nice and peaceful home." But one day we are to leave it. Imagine what it will be like in Jannah. Imagine that beauty in Jannah that will never be left alone. Living forever and ever. No dying whatsoever. Allahu Akbar. Khalidina fiha. Together with that, wa masakina tayyibatan fi jannati adn. And lofty mansions in the Garden of Eden. Allah is promising that. That is the promise Allah is making. But the greatest of them all, Allah says, as He ends that verse, wa ridwanum min Allahi akbar. But seeking the pleasure of Allah is what is the greatest. When we gain the pleasure of Allah, that is the greatest thing a man can get in his life. To make Allah happy, to make Allah pleased with what we see, with what we do, with how we behave. When we gain the pleasure of Allah, the ayat ends by saying, ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ. That, gaining the pleasure of Allah, that is the supreme success. Allahu Akbar. To gain the pleasure of Allah. So the question comes now, how do we gain the pleasure of Allah? We need to analyze ourselves on a daily basis. What did I do today to bring about Allah's wrath? What did I do today to incur Allah's pleasure? Ask ourselves daily, daily. Don't wait for every Friday or every year when New Year's come. No, daily. What did I do today in regards to my wife, in regards to my husband, in regards to my children? Don't forget yourself. Today we pray for everybody else except ourselves, you know. And some of us, we pray for ourselves, we don't pray for nobody else. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, dua was always what? Ummati, 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 ummati. The worry, the concern, it's about everybody else. Everybody else. Analyze our situations and see. Wa ridwanum min Allah. The pleasure of Allah, that is the greatest. How far are we? Or how close are we? This is the question. What am I doing to gain Allah's pleasure? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has done so much for me already. Allah has done so much for me already. What is it that I'm doing for Allah? We have to ask ourselves, my dear brothers, my dear sisters. Sometimes the doors to our work, it might close. We remain jobless. When one door closes and we cry to Allah, 10 more will open. This is Allah's wa'ada. This is Allah's promise. Sometimes we might be expecting a promotion in our jobs. Lo and behold, somebody else it's given to. When one door closes, Allah is not going to demote us. Allah is going to promote us in His sight. Allah is going to raise us. Allah is going to elevate us. When one door closes on one side, 10 opens on the other side. But sometimes what we do, we shut 10 doors just to open one. And the 10 doors that we have shut is all the good things that Allah has commanded us to do. So we won't pray, we won't fast, we won't do anything good, but we're expecting to get the best job. When we do come and get the job now, we can't fast again, we can't pray again, no Jummah, no nothing. So Allah opened one door for us, and we for our own selves, we incur Allah's azab now. This is how it happens. So we have to analyze our situation and see how much things Allah is doing for us. Allah is opening these eyes every morning with vision. With vision so that we can see. How many times we open our mouths and say, Alhamdulillah. How many times? Allah is opening this mouth from the time food touches your hand, your mouth starts to open. Are you doing that for yourself? It is Allah who is doing that. Allah is putting the taste in your tongue. Allah is doing that. Imagine this small morsel of flesh can tell you what is sweet, what is bitter, what is sour. This small morsel of flesh can tell you that. Who is doing it? Allah is doing that for us. The moment we touch something with our fingers, we can tell whether it's smooth, whether it's rough, whether it's soft, whether it's hard. Who is doing that? It's Allah. It's Allah. One little injection the doctor will give you, you know what happened? He numb your whole hand. You're touching everything now, you have no feelings. Allah can take that away without an injection. Allah can do that. We see people like that. So my dear brothers, my dear sisters, let us come on board and let us see what is it that we are doing to gain this pleasure of Allah, which is the greatest thing of all, the greatest bliss of all is the pleasure of Allah. Without pleasing Allah, without Allah becoming pleased with us, then in the akhirat, my dear brothers, my dear sisters, it's a different world. It's a world of doom. It's a world of chastisement. It's a world of punishment if we fail to gain the pleasure of Allah. The pleasure of Allah lies in following Allah and following His Rasul, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Practice this deen as much as we could do. Practice this deen as much as we can practice it. Hold on to the sunnah as much as we can. This is the greatest treasure for the believer. The believer has the greatest treasure on this earth. Something that the disbelievers, they are hungry and thirsty for. They want to know how to live the way of life that has been prescribed for them. They live like animals without any code, without any conduct. We have a pattern, we have a way. Just last night, subhanAllah, just last night for Maghrib Salah, a person from China came right here, took Shahada, became a Muslim. A young man, 25 years, says, I used to worship the Buddha, but I realized, this is his answer. I said, what attracted you to Islam? He said, Islam has a lot of good mannerism, akhlaq. SubhanAllah. The night before, a sister came, accepted Islam. What efforts are we making? Allah is sending them. Allah is guiding them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It shows us what? Allah doesn't need us. Allah doesn't need us, but we need Allah. We need Allah. So let us try our utmost and do those things that gains the pleasure of Allah. And let us try our best also to stay away from those things that Allah becomes displeased with, that Allah's anger is upon. Otherwise, lest we become like the Christians and the Yahud, those people who Allah says that they are dolin, they are misguided, those people who Allah's azab has befallen them. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect us from becoming like those people. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will continue to guide us and guide us in such a way that our hearts will be connected to Him. Our hearts will be attached to Him. Our lives will be lived in accordance to the Quran and the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Our living. Qul inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alameen. Our sacrifices, our efforts, our living, our dying. It will only be for Allah and Allah and Allah alone, who is Rabbul Alameen, the Lord of the worlds. May Allah bless us. May He have mercy upon us. May Allah show us truth as truth, falsehood as falsehood. And may Allah guide our hearts towards Al-Haq, towards the truth. Wa la akhir da'wana an alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen.